so they are cold-blooded. And on top of that, these guys have been in a pretty chilly lab. So a lot of times they don't just burst out of the box. But that's okay, we're gonna talk about. We're gonna show you guys. Like this one. This is a Central South American species. Now on the outside of the wings, lovely brown, which is fabulous for camouflage. When they take flight, looks like they're morphing to blue. Hence their name, the blue morpho. Now blue morphos are what we call decomposer butterflies. So actually, warmer days, you would see them nectaring on the trays of rotting fruit. Nectar off of rotting things, things like rotting fruit drops from the trees, decaying animal matter, and even animal fecal material.
Wow.
So now the butterfly lands on you. If you're okay with it, we're okay with it. So if you need help, you'd like to move the ground staff, we're happy to help you. Alright.
It's almost 3 seconds. Look at how
he's taking off.
Yeah, he's right. Alright, there we go. Alright, moving on to swallowtail species. The SOAS swallowtail, wave goodbye. Now, a lot of swallowtails or members of the swallowtail family don't have those tails. But one characteristic that we all do share is they'll beat their wings rapidly while they're not nectaring. They do so to avoid predators. If a predator goes to strike, this butterfly's already warmed up and can fly away much faster. Alright. Now, traveling over to Southeast Asia, these butterflies are called clippers. And clippers are pretty cool. They're color-coded. Based on their coloration, you can tell where they're from. So brown guys like this one are from the Philippines, whereas this bluish guy, you find them on the mainland. So it's pretty cool. It's kind of color-coded, just the location.